Board of India has indicated now that the re-examination for NEET that was being sought by the petitioners, by the NEET aspirants who alleged malpractices, that re-examination is unlikely to happen. The court had opined that there is not enough evidence on record so far to suggest that what has happened in terms of malpractices for NEET has impacted the entire examination or vitiated the entire examination process. Yes, the Supreme Court, based on the CBI status report, has acknowledged that there was a leak of question paper from the OSS Center in Hazaribagh. The CBI had in sealed cover apprised the Supreme Court of its investigation so far. An additional director level officer actually apprised the Supreme Court that yes, the paper did get stolen from an NPS center in Hazaribagh, and subsequently a full module worked to get the NTA aspirants, some of whom had paid up to 35 lakh rupees in post-dated checks. Conspirators of the Hazaribagh module, as per the Supreme Court, managed to impact one centre, but that does not mean that the entire examination affecting lakhs of students across centres in India have been vitiated. Essentially, what the court has told the petitioners is that we are not cancelling the entire examination process. We are allowing the counselling to go as the NTA has scheduled so far. But at the individual level, if there is any petitioner who feels that he or she is still aggrieved, then there is liberty being granted to that petitioner to approach the relevant High Court. For example, if a petitioner in Maharashtra feels there was an incident in Latur also, which the CBI is probing, but the CBI says that is a case of impersonation and not of paper leak, essentially making a distinction that in the case of Latur, also in the case of Godhra, and one case in Jodhpur, there were people who faked their identity, who pretended to be the NEET aspirant and tried to enter the examination hall to write the examination on their behalf. So, for example, if at these centres there are people, NEET aspirants, who feel that justice is not being done to them, the Supreme Court has given them liberty to approach the relevant High Court and seek justice from there. Instruction has also been given to the government to look at how to strengthen the National Testing Agency, and the government on its part has apprised the Supreme Court of India that ISRO chairperson, one of the retired ISRO chairperson, has been tasked to form a committee and look into the entire process of the National Testing Agency conducting its exam, if there are any strengthening that is required for the SOPs that NTA follows, and that former chairman of ISRO, whatever his recommendation is, will be followed to the T. So the sum total of what has happened in the Supreme Court is that the Supreme Court for now has not ordered a retest. However, it has acknowledged that there were problems at some centres. At these centres, affecting about 150 students, the paper did get leaked. How will this play out politically? That will be interesting to note. Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha still in session. This has become a big issue with the opposition demanding a discussion on NEET, demanding the resignation of Dharmendra Pradhan. So over the next few days, will the Supreme Court order finally put the lid on this controversy on the floor of the House, or will the opposition continue to agitate? That's the political question that is still being seen very closely. Judicially, however, this matter looks settled for now.